Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome to the Destiny 24/7 channel. That's what I said. You know, I know we've been talking about this Game Lounge 79, by the way. How you doing?
Hi.
We got Dosha and Mew. And you know what? We spent probably too much time talking about Destiny. So we'll speed it up.
So the T-Fury contest will have the winners announced next week, so keep your ears pierced. Wow, Pierce, peeled, and make sure you check Twitter, because I will tweet you guys whoever won.
Wait, is it too late to start doing the retweets and shit?
Well, it says it ends on January 15th, so today is the last day which we're recording on, but
it's too late to retweet now.
I feel like singing again.
Yeah.
Is that the Coco song? I still haven't heard it.
I'm in love with the Coco.
I keep hearing that. I've never heard the song ever. I haven't heard it.
Do it for the low, low.
And I want to see how long it go without Alyssa hearing it.
I don't know. You know what? It's funny. Just bring this up real quick, man. We talk about those songs that get popular that no one ever heard of, man. I still never heard the Friday song from Rebecca Black. I've met Rebecca Black. Still don't know the damn song.
Oh, yeah? What's she smell like?
Friday.
Smell like? I don't know. I also met Boxy the same time, so.
Boxy?
Yeah.
My name is Boxy.
Yeah, her. She's I like cute. Her. She smells good.
She's not a she's a character though. That really wasn't her.
No. Shout out to Katie Wayne. Cool peoples. Got a chance to hang out with her. She does like animal related videos now. She's a big I don't know if the word is animal activist. She's for the animals. Say that. She's not like on that PETA level where she'll slit your wrist if you wear a leather vest or something, but
oh god.
No, she cares for the animals, man. She's really loving with them. So, you know, shouts to her making big moves.
Yeah, animal rights and shit. That's cool.
Yes.
Yeah, whatever. I respect them. I respect you too, girl. I show respect towards my women and animals. but no, she was My Name is Boxy. And she had emo makeup on and stuff. She was like a big thing on 4chan. She was a babe before there was bae.
Yeah. Queen of 4chan. She still holds the title. Reign supreme.
Yeah, Queen B. But then a lot of them got mad when they found out she was a character.
Yeah.
Got crazy. People, fucking 4chaners, man. They found out where she lived and all that stuff. People.
I know.
Actually, she's okay. In all fairness, she kind of telegraphed it. She didn't have no problem really saying it. I was like, I don't think you would do that with a 4chan. But I don't know. I mean, It's kind of a give and take, because I guess the whole being you know how, like, you know, the bronies and the My Little Pony thing. If you say anything about the bronies, you had people on your ass ready to ride out.
Yeah,
dog. That's how they protect the Boxy name, even though she doesn't mess with it. She just kind of does her own Katie Wayne thing. So it's weird how that works. But she doing her thing, though.
What is it with dudes, prepubescent dudes, young guys? They just act so stupid. Dope it around a girl online, and it's like they get a shiny toy and they just want to break it and smash it and scare it away.
They're emasculated, man. It's the problem.
Because
they're emasculated.
Because something's been happening in my chat room lately. Sometimes I get a girl in there, you know, I'm happy to get one girl come around, and then these guys, they just start getting carried away and they want to do stuff with her, they want to get with her, and they just lose their mind because you're like, oh my god, it's a girl. I can interact with her. I'm like, yo, you need
you
to
know
chill
what?
Out. Show some respect, man. Like, I had to time someone out because this little kid was getting too damn horny in the chat room. Just
True that. Yeah, it's conditioning, man. Was it?
It was Slim. And she came in the video game. She was talking, being nice to everyone.
Oh,
and I guess
Slim got a little sexy voice, though. That's dangerous. Slim, hey. Be careful how you talk to
him. And I guess this guy, like, he was all excited because he never interacted with the girl before. You know, I don't know. He's like 13 or 14. I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like talking about he's going to marry her and all this shit. I'm like, he progressively, as the hour went on, he was getting more and more creepy. I'm like, okay, you need to stop. I actually had to put him on timeout. And I'm pretty chill for the most part.
You know, I'm just like imagining like a puppy that's like just humping her and you're trying to be like, stop. No, just no. No. The puppy's trying to hump her.
That's an interesting comparison. I don't know. I don't get that much in my chat. And I don't know if you've ever been in mine. I know there's mostly females in there. I don't know. I got a lot of female regulars, I guess. That's why. And I guess I'm making known straight out the gate. Nah, none of that over here. I don't know. They pretty tame.
I think girls are pretty tame. Remember what K-pop said? That they're really nice?
Yeah. Nice
girls,
and loyal.
Girls online are nice?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, they are. I never felt disrespected. I never felt like a piece of meat or any of that. No, but it just seems like to be a common thing. Just maybe it's just because you combine a young adolescent with anonymity and then a female, and it's just like a mixture.
Yeah.
Like a
combustible. It's like alcohol.
Yeah.
Just like encouraged.
A little cocktail. I don't know. I just noticed that. Get that stupid. Roke, so did we have any gaming stuff out of the ordinary this week?
Well, we did. We still have to talk about Destiny, but apparently there's a new song on Rock Band. That's kind of made me laugh when it was mentioned.
Yeah. It's crazy. Because Rock Band was one of my favorite games. Let me see. I don't even know what they added.
Hey, like, what is it?
It says Foo Fighters.
Avenged Sevenfold is what I'm hyped for. I like me a good Avenged song, especially on Guitar Hero.
Dude, and those games, Arctic Monkeys.
That is so weird. It is so weird. After 21 months. And then they're just like, oh, here's some DLC. They used to have DLC every week.
Yeah, I remember that.
And I bought that shit. I have probably 1,000 songs.
I think what ended up happening is that they got oversaturated. Like Rock Band. Remember how Guitar Hero and Rock Band, they would have, I mean, it was okay to have music, but they kept having physical discs out that you had to buy again. The Metallica pack, the, all that other stuff. I don't know. It got played out. And then Band Hero came out and then you had to buy a keyboard. It was just, a gimmick.
They didn't have a keyboard. Band Hero, that was Rock Band that had the keyboard.
Was it? Okay, yeah, Rock Band had the keyboard. Okay, well, what did Band Hero have? A ukulele? It had some unnecessary shit. It was just unnecessary.
Here's the thing. Activision's fucking greedy ass. They ran into the ground. They kept they're like they had this game that blew up, Guitar Hero.
Guitar Hero, yep.
And instead of going the route of, hey, let's update the game and then make a music store, like the iTunes route, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
They just kept pumping out fucking titles, so people had to keep buying more discs and more peripherals and shit like Band Hero. That was just another game. That's all that was. Another game.
Yeah, DJ Hero. Yeah. There's a whole bunch of them. Yeah.
But you know what's sad? People bought that shit too.
Let me tell you what. I had Guitar Hero and the guitars. I had Rock Band and the bass and the drums. I had DJ Hero, the wired and the wireless turntables. I was
you sound like my older brother. He's like got suckered into all that. He's like, look, Sally, I'm a DJ now.
And I was one of those. If y'all ever see me play any game, you know I gotta go for the ridiculous challenge, like the expert 5 gold star challenges. You know what I'm saying? That was Doge. Doge did that. That was pretty bad.
Yeah, dude, there was pro gamers and shit playing rhythm games.
Mm-hmm.
Like, remember, what's her name? Starscream or...
Star Slayer. CG, I haven't heard from her in a while.
CG. Yeah, she's a cute girl, man. She's still doing YouTube. Does she still do rhythm games?
A little bit of Guitar Hero here and there, but she's doing a lot of promo stuff. I forgot who. Last I remember, she was working with Google.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, CG. She's from Ultimate Gamer. You should watch those series. Our buddy Kelly's on there. Kelly.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, man. Miss Violence. Hey, boo-boo.
So that was a fun little series, but she's on there. She was on there with her ex-boyfriend. It was a funny show. They need to bring back some of those video game TV shows.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, man.
Put the gamers all in the house and they fight each other. But yeah, when they had her on there, it was when rhythm games was the shit. And so she was like the rhythm game expert. But yeah, I had that. I had the Rock Band whole set, the drums. I had fucking 4 guitars, dude. 4 of them.
Mm-hmm.
The microphones. It was basically interactive karaoke, and then it just like, I don't know, I guess it, people just were like, you know what? I'm playing a fake-ass plastic instrument. What am I doing? And then they stopped.
Which is funny that you bring that up, because then Rocksmith came out, and that was with an actual guitar, and that's still doing pretty good, but they kept to the model we've been saying. don't release a whole bunch of just the same stuff. Like, just keep one thing and keep updating it with the music library. That's what Rocksmith did, and it's working for him.
Is it really? I don't know. It doesn't seem that popular to me.
Well, of course it's not going to be as popular as the Guitar Hero Rock Band days, but it's still popular. Oh, yeah, it's working.
All right, so anyways, obviously this is on 360, PS3. And Arctic Monkeys, Avenged Sevenfold, Foo Fighters. I don't know any of these songs. I'd have to listen to it.
I think I know if it depends what it is, but I like Avenged Sevenfold and Foo Fighters.
So weird. I'm not getting them, but I have the game, but I haven't even touched them. I haven't even touched my 360 since Advanced Warfare. Have you guys touched your old systems?
No.
I've been on my PS3, I'll admit it. Back to Virtual Fighter. It may be a 6, so I gotta practice.
All right, real quick, Destiny thing. Hard Destiny mode. Thing. Hard mode Crowder, Wednesday, January 21st, 10 a.m. PST. Okay, they're not saying they're not saying all the shit, but it sounds like the chalice is going away. That's the thing that you pass between your friends.
Had a feeling.
That's not a big deal, because sometimes we pass it without taking any damage.
Right.
Man, we had a good run today. I mean, if you do everything right, it should be done in 2 minutes. But now I'm thinking, you think they're going to bump up Crota's health?
Probably. Going to have to. What level was Crota before? 33?
Shit.
They might make him level 34. He's 32? Okay, they might make him 33 or 34. Just because, if I'm right, level 33 is going to be the level of the new gear, right? Or you at least should be at least able to get to level 33 now. Something like that with hard mode. So yeah, that'd be interesting.
So you get new weapons, abyss of this, fang of that, and just all kinds of shit. There's a link, you can Google it. You get the necrochasm, and bada bing, bada boom. We spent half an hour on Destiny last time, and I'm sorry about that, but you know, we just get into the game, man. We like it. You know? Poor Sally had to deal with that. I was listening back to that. I'm like, damn, we talked a half an hour about that game. What a bunch of freaking nerds, yo.
I don't mind, because I know you guys are passionate about it and I'm mature enough to like let it slide.
Shoot, I hate that game.
We gotta respect you, Mew.
No, I'm totally fine about you guys talking about it, because I'm pretty sure there are people who actually care who are listening. And for those who aren't, you guys can suffer with me. We'll cry together in the corner.
All right, well, we're done. So it's hard mode. But we still play. I still stream it sometimes. Sometimes Dosha will join. We have fun. Those are some fun times. If you come to those streams, you'll find out some stuff about Dosha you never knew.
Yo, that, oh, shoot. Here we go.
Oh man. Dosha's closet.
I just bust out. But I didn't, that's not even, you see, that's not even true. There's no archives. It doesn't exist. He's making stuff up. He's just derailing.
Should I tell him what we found out about you?
You didn't find. All right. So anyway, what's the next topic of discussion? We were talking about.
All right. Well, the next topic is your voice cracked. Guess how many. It's like, you know, when you put in some video games, you can see how many people are currently online.
Yes. Yep.
How many are playing Minecraft? Take a wild guess. Actually, a
couple billion.
Too many.
What'd you say, Dosha?
I said a couple billion. Just making
a billion.
Numbers.
No, 998,000 people are playing Microsoft at this moment, and this is not even remotely close during peak time.
Wow.
That's crazy.
998,000, and that's for legit copies, not pirated ones.
Oh,
and
my God.
Not including PS4, Xbox, and all those.
Or mobile.
Mobile?
Wow.
What about mobile and also tablet?
No, this is PC only.
So that's a lot of people playing Minecraft just like alone.
They're
not even
not
counting
know.
Everything. Holy shit.
I did not know that Minecraft was that big. I mean, I figured it was something, but that's huge.
I'm shocked.
Me too.
I'm shocked. I'm thinking I need to quit Destiny and get some of that Minecraft money.
Do you remember when we used to do kind of Minecraft stuff, Mikey?
Mm-hmm. That's fun. I like that.
That was fun.
What are people doing in that game, though? Like, what's going on?
I know a couple of people who play Minecraft and do that for a living. Like,
oh, you mean what's her name? The pink hair girl?
LD Shadow Lady.
LD Shadow Lady. She's a sweetheart.
And, And then there's also Ashley Marie Gaming, which I knew her before she blew up. Or knew of. I hung out with her a little bit.
Who is it? Who else is there? My homegirl Sushi Sam. She does it. Cupquake. Sevidus.
Let me show you some pictures. And I'll have a link to this. You want to see how many people are playing Minecraft? Look at these pictures. This will tell you the result. The ass end result of all those people. Go ahead and...
you got to be kidding.
Google or search Notch. Notch is the guy who made Minecraft.
Oh,
Notch housewarming party. $70 million mansion.
Oh, yeah. Look at this. Didn't he outbid the mansion from Beyonce?
Beyonce can't afford this house. This is Minecraft money. He's got a fucking candy store in his house. He has a winery. Look at that candy. That's probably bigger than a candy store. He has a candy store. He has a fucking winery. There's more pictures elsewhere. Oh my, it's sick. He's got this crazy garage. Hold on. I think there's actually more. Oh wait, there's more pictures, right? Yeah. Click on the first link. Minecraft, man, it's crazy.
But you see, that's what happens when you make a deal with Microsoft, right there, period.
Okay.
Well, he was smart enough to cash in when he knew, like, he's just like, fuck it, I can just make money now.
Look at his pool, though. Look at overlooking LA. Look at that. What is that? I don't even know what kind of room that is. I've never even seen that room. That's like, I guess, a living room or a deck? It's basically like a casino. It's like a deck, and people got these big-ass chairs you'd find in a Vegas top-notch casino, and then it has a pool, an infinity pool.
I love infinity pools.
Oh my god, Notch. We didn't get that housewarming. Oh my god.
Does that girl on the left look like fucking, what's her face, Selena Gomez?
That's Selena Gomez.
This motherfucker's partying with Selena Gomez, dude.
Oh my god.
All that from Minecraft.
But to be fair, he probably had a lot of money already. And then to top it off with the cherry.
Huh?
Yeah.
Notch didn't have a lot of money. He was a little nerdy programmer dude.
No, I meant he had a lot of money since Minecraft.
Yeah, he made a ton from Minecraft. Then he sold it.
He made even more. Yeah. That's what I'm saying. Like, he had a lot already.
After he made Minecraft. I guess the question is, what's next? I mean, obviously this guy's making investments.
What's next? He's two girls at the same time is what's next.
He got Selena Gomez in the house. He got people sniffing girls' feet in his house. Like, yo, he's balling.
What?
You know, like look at these people out of there. All these hipsters. All these guys with their stylized hair and shit. Where were they? What? Where were they like 2 years ago?
I was going to say, these dudes look kind of corny. I'm sorry. They look like they just kind of fall in the chance. Like, there's a new rich person in town. Let's go.
Scroll down. There's Notch. And then there's just some little Kokor with her arm around him. Like, where was she? Like, she looks like a supermodel. Well, not really. She looks like... I'm being stupid right now. But isn't that funny? He went from this little nerdy video gamer dude... And now he's on the top of the world.
Well, he made a really good game that attracted a lot of people.
That's got to change you. Having $2 billion? $70 million ain't shit to him.
Just have to wait and see, Mikey, to see if he flips out with all that money or use it.
Is that what you do, Mew? $2 billion bucks? You just, you know, fuck it, I got to, because you can't keep that in the bank.
I'd want to have, like, a nice house.
You have to get property because you can't just have a bunch of liquid assets in there because, you know, bank could crash. Something horrible can happen.
I would invest.
You invest?
Yo, Mikey, you're being my investor, man. I'm learning stuff from you right now.
I'd definitely invest in a really nice house and then a couple of apartments in the city of New York and then just rent that shit out.
I think he's also investing in businesses. Like, he has to be.
Yeah. Or, like... foster some other, you know, indie games or some other shit. I don't know.
Little gaming studios.
Mm-hmm. He's got a bar, and he's got James Bond on it, like in three.
That's not a bar. That's a damn winery, son.
I know it is a winery.
It is literally a winery in his damn living room.
Probably also temperature controlled.
That winery is bigger than the top floor of my damn house, man.
That's bigger than my room.
Yeah, you can tell this dude's a 007 fan. I'm looking at the stuff he's got in his house. He is a big 007 fan.
So not only is the house $70 million, but that little winery, like, I'm sure that's nice wine. Like, they have a dollar value attached to them.
Yeah.
That's fuck, man, $200,000 in wine? I don't know. I have no idea. I'm just taking a wild guess. It's ridiculous. Look at that candy store. You're not going to eat that candy. It's going to sit there and just get stuck and rot.
Maybe it's just there for the party, though, because I see the M&M thing. Maybe it's sponsored, and they just brought that shit here.
Is he single?
I have no clue.
You're Dosha, would Mikey? Dosha, would you switch teams and get with Notch?
The fuck? I knew that she was coming. Ah, don't do this game. No.
I bet he's taken her. He has a lot of side chicks.
If you're single, would you consider going on a date with him?
No, maybe before he became famous, yes, but at this point in the game, he probably has a lot of side chicks, and I'm not all about being a side chick right now. Never been one, never will.
Nah, he looks like the type of dude it wouldn't change him as a person. Although last week, we're talking about time travel, and you guys were convinced, oh yeah, Mikey, if you become a millionaire, you'll change and all this. This guy's a $2 billionaire. And he's got this co-core around him. And he's got a winery. And he's got Selena Gomez chilling in his house. By the way, look behind Selena Gomez and those dudes. What is that, a damn fucking Ferrari just chilling in the living room?
Yeah, man.
So, he's changed. Or not. Or does he just have a bunch of fancy toys?
Well, I wouldn't know unless I, you know, hang out in his circle.
It's a 23,000 square foot home. He outbid Jay-Z and Beyonce. That's that Minecraft money.
Mm-hmm.
And so when you hear that there's 1 million concurrent users, shit, man, that's a lot. Like, what does Call of Duty have? Like, fucking 300K? I don't know. It's not that. What's League have? Do they tell you, or?
What do you mean?
What's that game that you're playing? I came in and watched
you. League of Legends.
League of Legends. Can you tell how many people are online? Do they tell you guys?
No, they don't tell us, but I think they have like 1 million people playing it like the same time. So
There's just so many video gamers everywhere. The world's changed.
Mm-hmm.
All right, are we done getting jealous over Notch?
I'm not jealous, because I don't think I would have been able to create Minecraft or something like it. I don't have the tools for it anyway. So.
Well, he didn't really create it. All he did was take Legos and put it into a video game format.
But nobody did that in the right way.
Well, I could have done it if I knew how to fucking program.
Oh, shatter.
That's the same thing as me going like, I could have invented eBay and PayPal, but I just didn't do it.
I thought of it first. I just didn't act on it, dog. You know what I mean?
Oh, we were talking about that earlier before we started. Just said, nah, I mean.
See, I think you got it from Dosha.
I think we got it from Mew, and then that's why we started saying it.
No. You know what I mean?
No.
She doesn't like us saying, nah, I mean.
I never said that. I picked out that, no, because I noticed that Mikey's been using nah, I mean a lot. I'm like, dang. I just said, you know, like, I noticed you.
She don't like the way I talk.
No.
She's jealous of us because she can't beat us. Hating on the vernacular, bruh?
No, I just noticed. And then when Nike tried to be like, no, it's you, I'm like, but I would have said, you know what I mean? That's actually what I would say instead of not me.
Man, we steal all each other's vernacular.
She's not on fleek. I don't know about this girl sometimes. You're not on fleek. We didn't talk about what Dosha would do with the $2 billion after he sold his Minecraft video game. Would you still do the podcast? Would you still be around us, talking to us?
Yeah, no. I would, but I guess I would be kind of a scumbag because I would try to get some sponsors on here to buy into some things.
I
would continue to talk our crap, you know what I mean? Like on some satellite radio stuff. Maybe get a syndicated.
Oh my God.
No, I'm being serious. Like, cool. If I had that.
I thought that's crazy cool.
Yeah, if I had the opportunity, I would try to get us syndicated. I would try to get us to do a podcast every day if that was possible and stuff
really
like that.
Really, Dosha, you will literally be a billionaire and you're going to fuck with this little tiny ass podcast.
Well, I mean, it wouldn't be little. You gotta think about it, man. There's nothing's little. Things start out small, but then look at how big Minecraft got. You never know, man.
Although you could pay to get PewDiePie on here.
I don't want PewDiePie. PewDiePie can pay me to be on that motherfucker. You know what I mean? Like that's what I'm thinking. Hey,
what's
right
wrong
here,
with PewDiePie?
You know? Nothing. Nothing wrong with PewDiePie. I'm just saying. All I'm saying is, I'm the type of person to try to take something small and make it grow. Mm. You know what I'm saying? I wouldn't leave this podcast. This is home. I don't ditch my home unless it's Connecticut. I hate that state. But other than that, I don't ditch my home.
Oh,
so
dang.
I would do something, take this, and make sure everybody in the family is eating. I don't want 2 million all by myself. What am I going to do with 2 million by myself?
2 billion.
What am I going to do with 2 billion by myself? I can't drive all the Ferraris.
Selena Gomez.
She ain't got no butt booty. She ain't got no booty. Her feet probably stink too. She can't come in my house.
What? By the way, why is Selena Gomez there? That's kind of weird.
That's what I see, right? I said
that's why thing. I was just questioning it.
She could smell that money. First she smelled it on Bieber, then she's like, "I'm gonna hit
see,
this. I'm gonna hit
learned,
a notch."
That's what I learned about that area, like the whole West Hollywood, Beverly Hills, anything over the hills, right? Santa Monica-ish area, Calabasas. They all fake. They all flock to each other because of the money, man. They shake each other's hands and glad hand and pretend they love and know each other. All because it's a business move, business venture. They all fake, you know? Just awkward. It was just awkward seeing Notch and Selena Gomez in the same room. It was just like, huh? That's just
kinda
weird.
Yeah, I'm wondering how the hell that happened because I'm thinking it would have been all his, like, gamer friends and programmer buddies. Like, hey, guys, we made it. I made it, but I'm bringing you guys here with me. Like, you know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
Like, started from the bottom, now we're here kind of shit.
Well, I think they are there. They're just not in the pictures. Or maybe we did see them, we just didn't notice them,
like,
you know?
Selena Gomez wasn't there when he first started.
Right.
Nope.
I'm not arguing that, exactly. I don't know, just...
But whatever, Notch, that's fine. I'm sure he hit it
though.
Afterwards.
Ew.
What? He's worth a billion bucks. Good for her, I guess.
She's like 12, dog. Ew.
Huh? No, she's not. She's 18 or 19.
A 12-year-old with an 87-year-old. That look weird.
Hey, speaking of Selena and all that, she dated Bieber. Have you seen the shit talking about your boy?
Yeah.
Is that real? I can't tell if it's real or
okay,
fake.
Okay, so I got a question on my ADA about this. Might as
okay,
well bring
so,
it up now.
So tell him what happened to Biebs.
So Bieber did a video shoot, excuse me, a photo shoot for, was it Calvin Klein? Underwear.
Oh, that one.
Took some pictures, you know, getting his sex appeal on, trying to look good, all that stuff, you know. That's what celebrities and stuff do. He'd been working out. He'd been in the gym. So, you know, now he had an opportunity to make a business deal. And they photoshopped him in the pictures.
Wait, and they did for a fact?
Well, for hell yeah, duh.
Well, they always do.
Well, okay, go on. Go and finish.
So, all right. So from designer to designer, like, this is no shock to any of us, but the social media lost their mind. They blew it so far out of proportion, and they're jumping on Justin Bieber like, you're such a fake. You can't show the real you. Those aren't your real muscles. You're a fraud, blah, blah, blah. And I'm thinking to myself, every celebrity that takes a photo for any magazine, anything of that nature. Like, look at Madonna.
Yo, she's so different to her photos to real life.
If you see her new album picture and then you see the way she really let's be real for a second. Madonna's damn near 80.
What's her new album called? New Madonna.
I forgot. She's got like barbed wire wrapped around her face. I forgot the name of it. But
all that? You can't even tell what she looks like though. She's hidden herself.
But she also does, like, she's got centerfolds and other pictures in her album cover, too. You'll see it at some point. But she's damn near 80. But she looked like she's, like, 25, 26 in those pictures. You know what I'm saying?
She has work done. I'm looking at just Google new Madonna picture, and you'll see her.
Well, she had more to work, though. She's been photoshopping hell, too.
Yeah, exactly.
You know
if and you see her live in concerts and to her photographs, you know shit's been done.
Well, that's what the fuck? She's 80. Hold on, let's find out. Madonna date of birth.
I don't think she's 80, though.
No, Madonna, she's not 80.
You make it so fucking.
No. I'm saying she's old as sin. She's
no, she's old.
Age.
She has wrinkles, which is natural.
She's
but...
56.
So,
56.
With that being said, the celebrities get photoshopped all the time.
Yes.
Everybody has imperfections, and Hollywood loves in the industry loves to cover those things up with not just cosmetic surgery, but photo retouching. So they spruced up Justin Bieber. They adjusted his muscles. They shrunk his head size. They bulged his cock out, all for the sake of selling underwear. And everybody's freaking out. And I'm like, why? This has been going on since forever. Are you guys just now getting it, or are you mad because Bieber's doing it?
I just think they're bored and they have nothing better to report, so that's news today, you guys.
I guess this is the same group that got mad when Kim Kardashian showed her juicy, glossy butt cheeks.
Exactly. Like, that's more important than whatever's happening, I don't know, Ebola, that which we all forgot about.
Yeah, we forgot about Ebola because of Kardashian.
There's a picture. You guys can Google it. Just Google Justin Bieber before and after Calvin Klein. Is this real, though, or did someone touch up the thing and make him look smaller?
Who knows? Like, well, he looks great either way, like, right? He's been working out. That's all that matters.
It doesn't matter because in the end, you know that he looks kind of similar to the photograph. It's not like he completely doesn't look like that. And if things are accentuated, it's because that's how things are done in the industry. Like, there's no control over that. I know in the UK, they actually can't Photoshop up to a certain point. Like, you can only do certain things. But after that, you can't do anything because they don't want to mess with women's images.
I think it's fake. I think it's fake because I've seen that package. No, when guys take pictures with their arms, we're always flexing and trying to be kind of doing shit. Okay, Dosha, look at the before picture.
Right,
that's not a real arm. He's not even flexing. You know damn well he would flex.
Mm-hmm.
You know he would flex even if he had a little puny arm. Why would he be relaxed like that? He would be flexing and showing off.
Well, either way, it makes no difference to me. Like I say, he still looks good. Who cares?
His chest is sunk in. Look at his right titty meat. It's sunk in. That's not natural. Someone's fucking with them. The cock bulge, who knows? I don't know. But this is tampered with. That left side, I can tell from the pixels, not literally. Because I do Photoshop shit, man. I'm in Photoshop every day doing titles, thumbnails. I'm cropping shit. I'm taking pictures up on the internet. I'm modifying them. I've done logos and websites and photo retouching. Like, I've been doing this shit for like 15 years. And this is a picture that someone fucked with and they're just trying to piss them off. Why would Calvin Klein release that picture? Why would they do something like that?
No, they would. You know what? I still say they would, to be honest. I don't know. I guess
have to be them. It could be somebody who, you know, in the inside, just leaked it for fun.
It could be anything, anyone, honestly. But the reality of what I'm saying is, you know, as also a graphic designer, I think all three of us are. We have a graphic design background, who's also done photo retouch, and that's industry practice in regards to, retouches, taking out the imperfections, patching things up. Like, there's a wrinkle under Bieber's, eye. What is it? His left eye. That's been touched out, you know what I'm saying? You know, simple things like that. They padded his face because his face looks sweaty. There's stuff like that. They smoothed it out. Like, there's stuff like that that we know in the industry because that's stuff we have to look at and pay attention and when we're doing, like, retouches or whatever. So, honestly, that's a common practice. It's not a big deal. It's been going on. Flip open your favorite magazine with a person in it. They've been retouched in some way, shape, or form. A good example I gave is who remembers Montana Fishburne? Lawrence Fishburne's daughter?
No.
Hopefully none of y'all. But here's the point. Once upon a time, there was this girl. Her name was Montana Fishburne. She was doing acting. We'll just call it that. So she had a video. And this was a natural video of her with no makeup. And she showed her backside, her booty cheeks, right? And she has a skin condition. So she had a lot of spots on her booty. A lot of dots and spots and freckles on her butt, right? And then she did a photo shoot, and they were not there. It was a photo shoot that was done probably a few weeks before the video was released, and there were no booty freckles whatsoever. And there was a big controversy because, like, everyone's like, oh, you photoshopped that, man. Come on, man. What's the real? It's like, well, that's the practice. And the proof in the pudding was so obvious that it was called out, but she had freckles on her booty. And they were not. It was just freckles. It was like, I don't know, like moles. She had multiple moles on her butt or whatever. and they weren't in the magazine shot or the centerfold. It's like, well, there you go, proof. Photoshop, it's real. That's just what happened. So get over it.
Yeah, you know? Well, you know, even Kim Kardashian in her fucking reality TV show, she does show, like, her photos untouched, you know, from the thing. And she's like, look, see, look, I have cellulite. That's natural. Mm-hmm. But in this industry, you're not going to, like, show flaws because people aren't going to buy the product. And it's our fault if you think about it this way. We're going towards the advertisements that's, you know, selling, you know, with perfect bodies. And why are we attracted to that? Why are we only buying bras from Victoria's Secret? Because they got hot models, right?
Yeah, and it's kind of sad, too, because, like, after that, people want to look like that now. You know what I mean? It's like, well, now I got to look perfect like them. It's like, they don't even look perfect like them. It's Photoshop. It's ridiculous.
Exactly.
Well, they're messing with this dude again. I don't get it. I don't get why people got to mess with Bieber when he's... It's people that, like, he's not even your demographic, or you're not in his demographic, I should say.
Mm-hmm.
Like, people go to his videos and dislike him. Why the fuck are you going out there seeking preteen music?
I think they're just jealous.
Know. Every time I hear about fucking Bieber or Kim Kardashian, it's on Reddit, a site that's mostly 30-year-old single males, and they're sitting there talking shit about, shit that's for teenage girls. Why are you, you know, making fun or in their biz?
Jelly.
But I think it's jelly. I think it's fake. His head is larger. There's just all kinds of shit. Whatever. It's good, Biebs. You know, you're rich. Is he a billionaire? Probably, huh?
Probably is.
Probably. Who knows?
Well, there you go.
Why do you? But either way, he got the endorsement. Get that money, bruh.
Doesn't matter. His fans will keep cherishing him. So.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Well, they'll show
they loving that bulge. They're going to put that on walls and stuff, like the mural. Oh, Bieber God. Bulge, the mural. That's right. I ain't going to do that, but they is, though. Huh?
What do you think about that picture? Do you like that picture?
What?
Mew? You like that picture of Biebs?
I think he looks okay, but I don't...
Not your kind of guy?
Care. No, I don't really care.
Huh. Who do you like? Who's like a sexy celebrity guy? I mean, if you're a single girl.
If I was single, I think the like guy I can think of, well, you guys would have to Google is Xbeke, and he's a he's a professional League of Legends player.
Oh, I'm done with you, man. Okay, let's. I'm done.
Can I just be honest? I don't like fawning over celebrities. I like fawning over guys that are actually like real guys. If that makes sense, like guys that I can see, you know, like, oh, this person I could totally meet, you know, somewhere in my city that may be like him. So I like Xbeke because he's like, you know, the typical gamer guy that's really good at a game I really like, and he's cute, you know?
Well, aren't you the perfect little person over here?
Why would I like, you know, Justin Bieber? He's a little bit too perfect, so.
All right, I'm just asking. He retired from music, though, right? Isn't he retired?
I don't think so. I think he's just taking his time making his next album.
You seen me working with Rick Rubin on a project? I could have sworn there was some gossip on the airwaves about him and Rick Rubin doing something together. He's like the granddaddy of hip-hop, in a sense. So, I don't know. No, I think he's cooking up something. He's in the lab.
All right, guys, real quick. GTA for PC, we have more new info. You want to hear it?
Tell me.
Sure.
We'll have to look it up first. No, GTA for PC, it's gonna have 30 people. It will be running at 1080p with at 60 fps. See, now that's what I want for console. Why can't they get that for console, man?
Maybe you should get that PC.
1080p 60 fps with up to 4k resolution and support for up to triple monitor. Damn.
That's some crazy ass setup.
Trying to see that 4K, though. Let's go.
That's some immersive ass shit. As well as NVIDIA 3D Vision I already said that. GTA for PC also includes the Rockstar Editor. You can make your own shit. So there you go. Link below. The specs are Windows. Oh, I'm not going to read all that crap, but it's typical game. Nothing crazy. The video card, NVIDIA 9800 GT. Well, I don't even know what in that crap is. I'm barely learning about PCs. It's not on Mac, though. I could see that.
Nope.
Windows 8.1, 64-bit.
Well, all I know is my PC is beast enough to run this shit. I'm happy.
Is it really?
Mine's not, but it'll be there soon. So
you see the specs at the bottom?
Yeah, I'm looking at it, and I'm like, yep, I'm set.
Processor Intel Core 2 Quad CPU. Quick, okay, you guys can look it up.
Although, to be honest, I mean, as a live streamer, I wouldn't run it at those settings just because it'll bog down the other viewers. You know what I'm saying? Like, most computers couldn't handle that. They'd be watching it. Most TVs could, like, most consoles couldn't even handle that. So I wouldn't bog down the connection with all that.
I think I would record, but yeah. I wouldn't stream that high. That's crazy.
Right, exactly.
That's a lot of streaming on your computer itself.
It looks pretty.
It does.
So around this time, we usually take the viewer questions.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and if you want us to talk to, leave a comment. That's it, a comment. Well, you can tweet us too. If it's something interesting, we'll save it. Ask
FM's been big now. Jeez.
But comments. Hashtag Vera question mute. You saw something, right? You saw something that cut the fancy eye?
Yes. You want to start with something random? Or you want to start with something meh?
No, something cool.
Okay. Valley the Gamer asks, hashtag viewer question, would you rather eat chocolate flavored poop or eat poop flavored chocolate?
Why is it always poop?
Why is it always chocolate?
Poop platter.
Okay, so what is it? Chocolate flavored poop or poop flavored chocolate?
Yes.
I don't know what poop tastes like.
Well, you're gonna find out. Would you rather eat poop flavored chocolate?
I know what it smells like. It smells like shit.
Would you eat chocolate flavored poop?
You know, I have no idea, but you know, maybe poop tastes good. Dogs eat their own poop all the time.
Obviously, they don't barf. I don't think they eat their own poop.
Huh? That's not. Yeah, they do sometimes. Throw up.
Oh, because someone's throw up, not poop. Whatever.
Continue. Well, that too. They eat.
So which one did you just choose?
Well, I'm guessing I'm gonna have to eat the poop chocolate because it just tastes like it. But it's not actually going to kill me. Because if you ate your own poop, that has toxins in it. That's toxic. So that would actually... So if I ate my poop, but it actually was like delicious, I'm going to kill myself. So that's kind of a no-brainer. At least in my opinion.
What about dosha?
I was going to say the same thing. Poop is toxins leaving the body. Why would I put that back in my body? I'm used to eating nasty things sometimes. I work out. It's a thing. Sometimes you got to eat crap that tastes like crap. So yeah. Bring on the chocolate, doodle flavored chocolate. Yeah, remember, you're also talking to a guy that ate crickets here. I mean, you know, about that life. It's nothing.
I get this guy's trying to be cute and funny with the poop question, but it's pretty cut and dry. It's scientifical and shit. Alright, what's next? Any other poop questions?
No.
What else we got?
Okay. Fox Lift asks, hey, YouTube dude and Game Lounge gang. I really like your content and I have a real question for you. Have you considered doing an updated or extended Getting Good at YouTube video guide? And he's watched your original stuff. So TLDR, he's watched that stuff. And he was wondering if you would even collab with Shidosha or Katie.
I also thought you might get Shidosha and Katie to do a collab on it. On my YouTube tips?
I guess so.
I need to do another one. I usually do that every 100K, and it's just a little reminder. But there really isn't anything new. Just make good videos. Make good videos and have a little bit of luck.
Be
consistent and stuff. I would probably say make content your viewers want to see. And I haven't been doing that because I get people telling me to make more Call of Duty videos, and I'm not doing it. Because I do what I want and I don't give a fuck. So you got to look at what you want to do. So, I mean, I like Call of Duty. I'm just not into it. Although I am starting to kind of get a little fed up with some Destiny shit. So I may be going back to it. I just had to take a break, bro.
You know, I've noticed that with, I think it depends where you are. Fox Lift as well. Like a lot of bigger YouTubers, they seem to, whatever they were known for, they're kind of straying away from it a little bit only because they've been playing it so fucking much that they need to play something else to kind of get their minds away. Like, I've been seeing Drifter playing League a lot. It's because you can't play Call of Duty nonstop. I can't see someone doing that, you know? Just like how Mikey straight away and played Destiny for some weird reason, but...
It's because in Advanced Warfare, there's 3 damn guns and 2 killstreaks that you can use. And you die in 1 second being shot in the back.
Oh my god. Yeah, system hack and that rolling shit with the missiles.
She doesn't like the rolling thunder. Trolling thunder.
Yo, it's always nonstop. If I'm not getting zapped and hacked, I'm fucking like shaking around.
Yeah, what I was going to say was... sometimes I feel it's kind of scary to be stuck into a single game.
Yes.
But then, look at Captain Sparkles. All that dude has been posted in Minecraft, and he's blowing up. And obviously, people like Minecraft because there's a million people concurrently online playing that shit.
Mm-hmm.
That's just concurrent. So that tells you that, fuck, there's probably like fucking 5 million people playing that game. Like, total. Like, the active user base. That is a big ass user base, and a lot of them want to watch Minecraft videos, so good for him.
Mm-hmm.
I just have no idea what's going on that game. I really don't. Like, I know people build computers and things like that, right? They build, they do Hunger Games and shit.
I always tell people, man, if you get into Minecraft, start with the dragon.
Okay. They have a lot of people either do is like mini commentaries where they're like talking about what they're doing or like they're playing with their friends, and you just so happen to know people who are famous as you go along building up your thing. But you guys have to also remember that if you're going to something like Minecraft, you're going to be competing with a bajillion people. If you're going through Call of Duty, you have less people to compete with because there's not a huge base, I guess, if that makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
Or
yeah.
Halo.
Oh, well, yeah, no, no. Call of Duty.
I'm just saying
compared to Minecraft.
If
but,
you
I mean,
compare
yeah.
to like the saturation of videos, Mikey, of who's in the Minecraft scene and who's in the Call of Duty scene, like if you were trying to go to either one, I would say penetrating the Call of Duty scene is a lot more easier than the Minecraft scene.
You gotta form alliances, man. That's what everyone's doing now. You know, you gotta make a team. You can't just like trying to roll alone and do videos is rough.
I will say Shadosha. Nowadays, it will be very hard to ask anybody for help. That's for sure.
Oh, yeah.
It's difficult. Wait, what do you mean help, like to stream with or, like, make videos with or?
Like, I at the time when I met certain people, like, Ashley Marie Gaming, she was, like, she had, like, 10K when I met her. And she's now, like, 100, 300, 400, 500K right now. I don't know. I can't even count. But... she grew so much.
What's her name? Ashley Marie Gaming.
Yes.
Never heard of her. And I never heard of her. She had nothing.
No, she actually exploded more than fucking LD Shadow Lady, which is crazy. So.
I know. Fucking, what's Shadow Lady's real name? It's Lindsay, right?
Don't know, because I really don't call her, but I don't call anybody that I know in the gaming world by their real names. It feels like boo.
Ashley Marie, she's almost 500K, 472K. I never heard of this bitch.
She knows, she plays
I'm sorry, why did I say that? I've never heard of that girl.
Mikey, she has like, I think she somehow, you know, obviously met the right people. Obviously, and they brought her with her, you know.
That's what it becomes now, you know. Well, you know.
But, you know, like I said, at the time that we were starting.
Right.
She was just there, right time, right everything, you know. Obviously, she has talent too, but I'm just saying, like, it's really luck, talent, and just perseverance, I guess. You can't just give up, so.
I'm making a video about this, by the way, stuff like this.
Because not everybody's going to be found. Like, there's always going to be, like, you know, that rough patch. Not everybody can get up there.
True. There's a plateau. But if you can reach out.
I'm telling you.
It's Lizzie. That's...
Lizzie, oh my God. Now it's complete. Because now I'm like, oh, yeah, that is her name.
Well, because don't you call people by their gamer tags or their usernames and shit? Like, that's why I started... that's why I switched over to using Mikey more. It's just that's my name, so like no one's calling me you know, YouTube guy and shit like that. But yeah, it's Lizzie, Shadow Lady, because we just call her Shadow Lady. Hey, Lady, Shadow Lady, what's up, girl? Actually, I don't say that. Yeah, she's cool people though. I play with her once, played some Minecraft.
I did, you know, always. I did ask her originally when we first started if she wanted to come to the podcast. Yeah, but get on her. No, her, just like how Winter can't come onto the podcast, it's because our time zones are too different
right now. We'll have to work around that.
It would be fucking super duper early.
I like her. I've seen, I don't really watch the Minecraft vids, but I like her little vlogs or her Sims and shit like that. It's tough to watch all these channels.
I know.
But I actually saw her on some different channel, some World of Warcraft thing. But yeah, she's one of the people that just, like, sometimes it's just weird, like, huh? LD Shadow Lady, she's 700K. That's weird. You can't really predict YouTube and stuff. And I don't really think I need to make another How to Get Big on YouTube or any of that crap, because nothing's really changed. I'm just taking
it as it goes. It's really the same old stuff, but you guys can't think like, oh, I'm going to be the next big thing. You should just think about making good videos, and, you know, if you're lucky, you'll get found or people will find you.
To be honest, I think he just wants to see me and Slim in one of Mikey's videos. You know what I'm saying? Just to add to the added value.
Like another GTA video or something? I don't know. We'll do something.
Something.
It'd be nice if Xbox One allowed you to record voices, but we'll have to have a workaround.
Yeah.
Like a TeamSpeak. Oh, well. Anyways, long story short, I'll make another tip thing, but there's nothing really new to cover. Professional speaker over here. What I will do is the feature me, the viewer of the month, whatever. Okay. I've been kind of busy. I've skipped it for 3 months now, but I'm going to get back on that. So I'll do that. So that's a way to get known. If you make cool vids, I'll look through that. We have the podcast thing, obviously, coming up pretty soon.
Yes, we do. So you have an opportunity to shine.
Yas.
Yas, bitch, slay.
Oh, God. Is this 2014?
Yeah. Wait. I just have to point out, Foxliff, you did not mention me, but I won't hold it against you.
Oh, dear Lord. All
right, what else we got?
Okay. Coltrane Gaming asks, hey, Mikey, I have a question for your podcast. What is your favorite childhood game and why? By the way, I was on your stream Tuesday. We'll get you to 30 million. Smiley face. Oh,
30 million? I don't understand. Huh?
No, okay. So I made a joke in your stream one day. He was asking for you to show. All right. So let me just background story. For some weird reason, he was asking. He's like, Mikey, what do we got to do to get you to show your sweet chocolatey nips? You were away. You were not at the desk. You went up to do something. I think.
I went to go smoke some crack.
Yeah, exactly. So I made a joke in your stream, and I said, all right, so the only way this is going to happen is like this. If we give Mikey the 30 million subscribers on YouTube, I will tell him to think about considering maybe a half a piece of nipple. I said it just like that, too, a little half a piece of nipple. Just for you, for getting to 30 million. So now that has been his golden light, to get you to 30 million subscribers. So that's what that 30 million is about.
That sounds amazing.
To clear it up.
Favorite game, probably the same shit like everybody, Mario Bros. Nothing original. Sorry.
How about you, Dosha?
I've answered this on my ADA, Gunstar Heroes. It's my personal favorite game. Sega Genesis. I'm a Sega boy. So, yeah, that's me.
How about you, Emil?
I guess childhood-wise, I've always said Duck Hunt. It's engraved in me. I love having the peripheral of a gun.
The classic.
Ooh. Yeah, and I was tiny, and I would come up to the fucking tube TV. Remember the glass tube TV?
Yeah,
and
man.
I would cheat before Game Shark came out. I would go up to the glass and shoot at the ducks.
Just put the gun to the screen?
Yes, yeah, you're exactly. It was definitely kissing the screen.
Cheater, yep.
You're welcome.
All right. Anything non-gaming?
Okay. Gabriel Hernandez asks, is it bad to be a flirt, and can it affect you in the long run?
Is it a guy or a girl?
I'm assuming Gabriel sounds like a guy.
Is it bad for a young teenage boy to be a flirt? I think that's probably normal, right?
Yeah, it can affect you in the long run. But
well,
it just
what about him being older, too?
Well, he's not older. Right now, it's fun. He's 16. He's young, dumb, and full of fun. And it's great. You should do that right now. Get a feel for girls and be social with girls in real life. So that way, you know, when you're in the chat room and a girl comes onto the stream, you don't act stupid.
You know how to behave yourself. Oh, dang. On blast.
And so it all comes full circle. So I think it's fine. It's just when you're in a workplace and you're an adult, you got that out of your system. See, so right now you're that a kid. True. Right now you're a kid and you're having fun and you're in high school. And yeah, be flirty. And I mean, don't be too crazy. Be respectful. Respect women. But then when you get older, you need to tone it down. But see, by that time, you've already gotten most of that out of your system. Trying to get all freaky. And I think women, once you're like older in the uni, college, workplace, whatever, they're not going to put up with that nonsense of some horny bastard, you know, around the office, some creep. So it's fine. It's fine for right now to be really flirty and stuff. That's what you're supposed to do as a kid, I think. Right?
Well, it just depends. He can flirt all he wants, but if you're in high school and you're dating, you better be careful about who you flirt with. You can get shitted on if that girl finds out.
You know what?
Just saying.
No. I think actually that's the reason he should flirt. He needs to learn exception and rejection and all of the ups and downs of flirtationships. You know what I mean? He's got to do it.
I know, but I said like up to a certain point, like in high school, you should take your, if you're going to be in a relationship, kind of try to be serious about it and not try to flirt around. Because I know guys who are, you know, in college or university who act like douchebags, and some girls will be put into that treatment because I guess in a way they ask for it because they can leave, but they don't. And you have these guys abusing girls and just flirting around, which right. I appreciate.
And I think that's what we mean by the effect in the long run. That right there is case in point as to one of the side effects in the long run,
like
to excessive flirtationship. You got to be smart about it. So yeah, you mm-hmm. definitely get it out your system now and
that grow far. Up.
Yeah, yeah, you know what I mean?
Feel me? You feel me?
All right, anyways, we're acting stupid now. So I think we're done with that area, right? Unless we had something super duper interesting.
Well, I wanted to ask you this, and someone
asked. Oh, you have a question?
No.
Mew question?
Someone asked. I don't know. He can maybe comment too, but I was wondering what he was also saying. He says, Dylan Loester asks, League gameplay in the Knicks game lounge. Is he talking about Call of Duty or is he talking about League of Legends?
I think he wants to see League of Legends. I don't give a fuck. Mew's going to have to provide it though.
I don't mind providing that.
It doesn't matter. One of our, we had what was it when Blizzard Squad hacked everybody?
Yeah.
We had a week where there was no gameplay because I got the gameplay that day, later that day, whatever. Couldn't get any gameplay. Couldn't get online. No footage. It was the most beautiful thing because, boom, that video went up quick style. It was like 10 megs. Boom. It took like 10 minutes or 5 minutes to upload. I was like, oh, that's awesome. Because normally it takes an hour and a half, 2 hours just to render out the fucking thing. That's not including exporting all the fucking footage, the video, which most people aren't even looking at.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Then I gotta upload that bitch, and I just fucking, I go to bed when that happens, so I don't even know how long that takes, probably 2-3 hours. So it was great when we had no footage, and I would honestly like to do that more, but I know people like it, and things like that don't do well on YouTube, on the YouTube version. That's why, by the way, that's why the iTunes version is what, it's like up at Thursday midnights. So the iTunes people, they get it really early.
They're the peeps that don't care about visuals and just want to hear our voices.
It's a podcast, though. It's about the audio. Yeah,
of course.
So anyway, what was the question? Oh, so League? Yeah, I don't care. Well, just have some video game footage. Yeah, and Mew wants to... Maybe, Mew, all you gotta do is post some footage on YouTube, and then I'll just rip it.
I will definitely do that.
So how long is the gameplay? Like, aren't those like an hour long?
It can go up to either 16 minutes or up to 35.
See, the only thing I could think of is big majority of our audience, or mine, or ours, whatever, is they're not really into League, but whatever. I don't know. What do you guys, leave a comment. What do you want to see? Because
I'll just give you one game that's probably like 16 minutes. That isn't like crazy, has full of action. It's a different, everybody's just on one lane, 5v5. So that should be more entertaining. And people are chucking snowballs at each other. So, and we'll see what happens.
Because at the end of the day, it's really just about the audio.
Mm-hmm. I mean, people did say they're getting sick of seeing Destiny footage, so.
They did? Who said that?
No, I'm just saying people are like, when they're like, oh, we don't want to see Destiny stuff, well, would they want to see some League stuff on the podcast?
All right, leave a comment. Well, YouTube people, I highly doubt YouTube people are, I don't know, whatever. Hey, are we going to talk about Leela?
Leela.
Are we going to talk about the kid? It's kind of a sad story. Are we going to talk about the sad story now, or should we wait again?
No, let's talk about it now. I'm a big girl.
You're a big girl, can handle it, or a sad time. Maybe we'll find a good story. Let's talk about Leela real quick. Leela Alcorn, she was 17. Let's go off this page real quick. Daily. You know what I like? I'm starting to like Daily Mail. And I know they're a tabloid, but I like them because they post shit that American websites can't do.
Okay.
Like, they don't give a fuck. They flat out post a lot of stuff that gets taken down or censored over here, I've noticed. Okay, so suicide. So basically, Leela, 17-year-old transgender girl, she committed suicide. You know what a transgender is?
Is it someone that's transitioning between sex post-op, pre-op, or whatever?
Okay, I guess you're kind of right. It's basically if you're born a boy, but you feel like you're a girl. Or you're born a girl, like you have a woman's body, but you feel like a dude.
Mm-hmm.
It's not being gay, because like you want to dress like a girl, you want to do girl shit. Or if you're a girl and you're like a tomboy, you don't feel right. I don't know. I'm not inside their brain. I don't fully understand it. Not gonna lie. Actually, no, I do kind of understand it a little bit. I've been reading into it. She actually had a Reddit account.
Uh-huh.
And I just couldn't help myself, and I had to look at it and I just read through it. I felt so bad. So basically. She was seven. He was born Jacob, I believe, Jacob Alcorn, and he was in a super religious family. And since he was 4 years old, he wanted to be a. He just felt like he was a girl. He wanted to be a girl.
Mm-hmm.
So he's 16, right? 16, 17, and he wants to start taking. Or she wants to start taking, what's it called? The transitioning drugs that...
So, just hormone pills?
Hormones. I think it's a shot.
Like estrogen shots?
Estrogen, I guess. Man, I'm so clueless. I don't know what exactly it is. But you take this and it helps, I think it like stops hair growth. Your skin gets softer. It's like estrogen. It just completely eliminates the testosterone. He wanted that, so that way it makes transitioning easier later on. And his parents are like, what? Jesus does not make mistakes. And they cut him off from social media. They took him out of school. Like, everything. He was basically a prisoner. He could only, like, go to church, and that was it. Like, can you imagine being 16 and that's it? You just go to church, and then you come home. No cell phone, no computer. No school. You're being homeschooled now because they think that you're being influenced by, you know, the world and shit. That's tough. That's crazy. That's like being a prisoner, right? Am I right?
Pretty much.
It sounds like olden days when you were homeschooled on the farm and there's nothing other better to do.
Leela said, fuck it. After a while, she was like, I'm a prisoner. She didn't see a way out, and she had a big suicide note that was scheduled on Tumblr, because, like, you know, it's like YouTube or Facebook, any of these things, you can write down your shit and then you set it to publish at a different time.
Uh-huh.
And you can read it. And she just went on that, I don't know if I want to read the whole thing. You guys should really read it. It's pretty deep. But how she felt alone, and she's like, that's it, I'm done. My parents aren't going to let me do this. It's going to cost me so much. And they didn't. She just felt alone. And she snuck out at 2 a.m. and jumped in front of a tractor trailer. Which, by the way, is kind of jacked up for the driver. Just saying. Leela, come on now. Anyhow, so she had her suicide note on Tumblr, and then her parents had it deleted. So she blamed her parents for her despair and begged others to respond, and she said that her death should mean something. And that all her possessions should be sent, and her bank account, whatever money she had, should be sent to trans organizations to help them out. And it's actually one of my viewers said, what do you think about this and stuff? I like to think I'm not like some wacko left-wing liberal or any of that stuff. But I think these parents should kind of feel a little responsible for this in a way. No, I think they did. I think they should feel responsible. I think, because the way that they're treating this is they're refusing to acknowledge any of this. They keep calling him Jacob, and on his tombstone it says Jacob, a son, and all this stuff. People are wigging out over it. She's getting death threats. Like, it's crazy. People are acting crazy. Like, she had to hide her Facebook. Like, the parents are, like, in hiding now. Have you seen the pictures of what she looked like? Or he?
Yeah, I'm looking through the pictures.
They don't like any of this stuff. They want it all taken down. But you can't take something down off the internet. Once it's up, it's up.
Yeah.
Once it's up, yeah.
So what happened was, the parents sent her to transition, or no, god damn it, conversion therapy. Conversion therapy is basically where they try to convince you that you're not gay or you're not trans or any of that stuff. And they said, no, this is wrong, and this isn't what God wants. Like, they were just all about Jesus and stuff. I think this is just me talking. They're fully responsible. They made her feel unwanted, basically. They didn't give their kid any support. They killed him. They killed her. You did that. Good job. In the name of your loving God, that's what you did.
And what I think what's even more just disgusting about this whole story is the fact that, I mean, at no time were they willing to acknowledge this child's decision, like, at all, even in their death, because his tombstone still says Jacob. What a slap in his face, her face. You know what I mean? Yeah. Damn, that's your child. You brought it into the earth. And, you know, I don't know, maybe, you know, growing up, you know, my family, when the little bit of time they were there, you know, they still taught me the rights of decision making, and that whatever choices are made is something I have to live with. And, you know, they're God fearing people. I'm not in a religion, and that's by my choice, you know. They never disowned me like that. Like, dang, it's like you couldn't even take a time out your day to just let the child know you love them. Said she nothing. Yeah, they killed them. They did it.
Well, you know, it depends what part of the country you're from, because they take Christianity or whatever religion very closely. Right, right. I've noticed, like, I've seen, like, I forgot what it was, but, like, wife swap. There are very religious Christians that do not believe women should, you know, be working at all, and they should just stay at home and do nothing. Well, you know, obviously clean the house and stuff, but that's scary to me.
Like, yeah, it's all culture and religion. It's so difficult, yeah, you know?
There are women who don't go to school because they believe in that women should just stay at home, which is scary. But like I said, like, this is really sad that on a level where if you peel back, you know, religion and just human to human, your child is calling out for help and saying that, you know, he doesn't feel like he belongs in a boy's body and
he feels like he's a girl, you know, and you should really talk about that instead of trying to, like, aggressively go against it. Because, you know, when you tell someone to, like, hey, don't smoke, they're going to start smoking a lot more. Like, yeah. How has that ever helped anyone out? So by trying to understand them and supporting them, maybe, you know, they might change their mind. Maybe they won't, you know, but and then that's your child.
That's a lot to ask, though. Like, and the parents' defense, though, this little child that you raised for the past 16 years says, you know what? I'm a girl. I want to be a girl. Like, that's a lot, though. That is mm-hmm. a lot. Like, I know none of us have kids. Well, maybe not. Maybe not two of us. But, I was fucking around. No, this is serious. But don't you, like, you have, like, little nieces and shit that you help raise. You know, I have little cousins mm-hmm. and stuff. Maybe been around kids. I've dated baby mamas. That's a big thing when you've been around them for a while. Like, you're like, huh? Like, how would you react when one of your nephews, one of your nieces, like, I'm a boy, I'm a girl now. I feel like this. Like, that's kind of that's a big thing.
Well, one of my cousins who I raised, she's gay. Straight up. One day she came out and said it. I'm gay.
Uh-huh. And did you show her the Bible or him the Bible?
No, I just fucking didn't do that. Like, Bible like, honestly, to be honest, I felt so indifferent about it. I was like, to be honest, that has nothing to do with me. I respect that. Thank you for telling me. You should tell your father that. But even more so, that's not going to stop me from... Like, I've known you for so long. That doesn't change the way I think about you. That doesn't change anything else that I know about you. Just, I know you like girls. Okay. You know, thanks. I mean, I don't feel bad. I don't hate her at all. I love her. It's still the same. It's no big deal. It's really no different. So, you know, I think that she should have the liberty to live life the way she wants. You only get one life, you know? Who's to tell you how to live it?
That's not fair. That's great. And I'm glad you're a wacko left-wing liberal. But imagine you have this baby.
You're from Connecticut, so.
This baby for 16 years, over a decade, and now they want to be a woman? You want to be a woman? That's a lot. Mm-hmm. And by the way, I'm not very happy with these parents. They fucking disgust me. They piss me off. But I understand them. I put yourself in their shoes. That's their baby that all of a sudden wants to switch sexes. Actually, it really wasn't all of a sudden.
She knew when she was 4. Yeah,
she said, and these are her words, quote, to put it simply, I feel like a girl trapped in a boy's body, and I felt that way ever since I was 4. I never knew there was a word for the feeling, nor was it possible for a boy to become a girl. So I never told anyone, and I just continued to do traditionally boyish things to try and fit in. When I was 14, I learned what transgender meant, and I cried of happiness. After 10 years of confusion, I finally understood who I was. So it wasn't like all of a sudden, I want to start, you know, being a girl. She knew, she felt it. You know what I mean? I mean, we're complex creatures. Sometimes, you know, the wiring gets fucked up. Know what I mean? But a prince like, no. God doesn't make any mistakes. That's in here somewhere in this suicide note. It's a big suicide note. You should read it. Get a better scope.
But yeah, I seriously think it's just the way the parents, their environment, wherever they're from, that influences how they think. While maybe Shadoshin and I have a different understanding where we just accept people who they are and how they are. Because I wouldn't care if my kid was gay, straight, whatever they fucking want. I will support them. As long as they don't hurt people.
Okay,
but that's... If you hurt someone, that's different.
But that's different than your kid wanting to switch sexes at 16.
They can switch sexes if they want. But I would rather wait till they're 18 to really decide what they want. And they will save up to do it for themselves. Because I'm not spending that much money.
I don't know. You know what? I think if, you know, in a situation like that, maybe just because of the way I am, that's a hard decision to make, seeing as how I don't have any kids. But if I could teach my children anything, it's how to live with the decisions they make. I can't really give that answer as somebody that doesn't have a child. I don't know how I'd feel. But I know that no matter what, I don't want my child to throw their life away, period. You know? That much I know. You know? So if I teach my kids anything, it's something that I kind of wish... Well, no, actually my family did teach me. It's a little bit of the hard way, but they still taught me how to make my own choices and decisions and live with them, live with the responsibility, live with the consequences, all that stuff. So like that's more important, more so than anything. Who and what they choose to be, that's on them.
Yeah,
really, that's their life decision. Because I ain't gonna be there the entire time, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
So it is what it is.
Yeah, we're all liberals here. We want everyone to fucking do what they want to do. Same thing. If my kid wants to be gay or straight or whatever, I don't give a fuck. I will be honest though, and if I had a 6-year-old and they said, you know what, I want to be a girl now. Okay, let's say let's say I was Jacob's dad and say, you know what, I want to be a girl now. And I'd be like, okay, how about you wait till you're 18? Because 16, like, we all remember being 16. Like, you think you know it all, but you really don't know shit. You don't have life experience. Mm-hmm. I would have said, listen, kid, wait 2 more fucking years. And if you still want to do that, then
yeah, that's reasonable. Because, you know, you don't want them to go through, I don't know, being harassed in high school or something like that.
That'll be a fun 2 years, I tell you what. But no, I can't disagree with that. You know, those are the rebel years. That's why I say that.
Because like, you're fucking...
You don't know what you're talking about, Mom. Shut up.
But, you know... I would be like, you can do whatever you want, but just if you could wait 2 years, you won't get bullied and stuff because you'll be asking for it.
I'm going to let them do it. Then I'm going to be like, what have you learned?
Yeah, exactly.
Fuck it. You know what I'm saying? That's how I was raised. I'll put my hand on the fire. If I get burnt, it's my goddamn fault. He's like, you want to touch that fire? This is exactly what my dad and my cousin used to say to me. He's like, you want to touch it again? Go ahead, touch it again. How about you touch it again? You know?
Layla, Jacob, they weren't getting bullied though. They had a lot of gay friends, so they had gay friends and support and shit. So they really weren't getting bullied. I think for the most part, people are pretty understanding. A lot of kids are understanding in this day and age because the internet kind of has spread the knowledge. Hey, come on, let people just do what they want to do. Okay, as long as it's not hate speech, they're not hurting anybody. Who cares what they want to suck on, what they want in their mouth? You know what I mean? Let them do what they want to do.
God damn it.
Oh my
so,
God.
So honestly, I would have been like, listen, just wait till you're fucking 18. That's it. But that's a big thing. Lila didn't want to wait till she was 18 because it's like the younger you start, it's better. You become more womanly. Whatever. So we would have had a disagreement there. The other thing is, I'm not super duper fucking God-fearing Christian, whatever, like his parents. And those people, I guess, like this is a touchy line. And so, I don't know if we have any super religious listeners, and I hope I'm not like offending anybody. I'm sorry. That's just not my belief system. But in a way, it's like that is just how you've been sort of, I don't know what other word to use besides programmed, like those Muslims that went wacko. Like that's,
I was going to say extremists.
They're extremists. The Westboro people, the Muslims that just can't fucking handled their Prophet Muhammad being drawn, they flipped the fuck out. And they had to go shoot up a damn newspaper building because they couldn't handle it. Because they've been brainwashed. The Westboro Baptist people, they go and protest the soldiers' funerals. They say God hates fags and they're promoting hate speech. Really? To the Muslims, to the radicals and the extremists? Someone said, Mikey, they're not Christians. Don't call them Christians. Well, they identify themselves like that. I don't know what else to call them. Westboro Baptist Church, whatever. They're so fucking brainwashed and so extreme. I'm not saying that Leela's parents were brainwashed or anything like that, but they were so ingrained in that culture. They could, like, really? Do you think Jesus really, like, that's their God, Jesus. Would he really want Leela to have this, to just die and commit suicide? Is that what your loving God would want? The same thing goes to those extreme Muslims. Really? That's what Prophet Muhammad wants? He wants you to go into a building and shoot people? Really? So it doesn't make any damn sense. So I think that the parents obviously had a really big part in having their son/daughter killed, but I'll have to admit, I can understand that's a big ass thing to have a person that you raised for 16 years and in their eyes all of a sudden wants to transition. Like, that is a big thing. Okay, I'll give that to them. I get it. But you gotta support your kid these days.
I just think they could have handled it better. Like, they could have done what you know said, Mikey, and you know, wait till you're 18. You can do whatever you want on your own.
Transgender suicide number, it's crazy, dude. It is so insanely high. They're like the number one risk of suicides. It's like, it's an asinine number. What is it? It's, I don't know, it's high. I don't want to fuck up the number, but it's scary high. So, anyways, be understanding. Let your kid do what they, I don't know, it's very difficult. Like I said, I tell my kid to wait till 18. Just, if you want to transition, fine. Do it at 18. I really don't care. Just be happy. Why don't you be happy? I'm not going to tell you I don't love you. I'm not going to take you out of school and make you feel like a damn prisoner, because that's what they did. Made her feel like a fucking prisoner. Of course that's going to make a kid want to... Like, everything that they were doing, like, not showing them love, not showing them support, taking them away from their friends. Like, she had no friends. None for, like, a whole summer or whatever it was.
It can make someone go crazy.
Yeah, at that age. Like, your body's already going through crazy shit as it is at 16. Anyway, so the suicide note concludes... Anyways, that's the gist of it. That's why I feel like I want to kill myself. Sorry if that's not good enough reason for you. It's good enough for me. As for my will, I want 100% of the things that I legally own to be sold, and the money, plus my money in the bank, to be giving to trans civil rights movements and support groups. I don't give a blank which one. The only way I will rest in peace is if one day transgender people aren't treated the way I was. And that they're treated like humans with valid feelings and human rights. Gender needs to be taught in schools. The earlier the better. My death needs to mean something. My death needs to be counted in the number of transgender people who commit suicide this year. I want someone to look at that number and say, that's fucked up, and fix it. Fix society, please. Goodbye. Leela Josh Alcorn. And that was it. And got a lot of support, man. Hashtag Leela Alcorn. A lot of support from everybody, and the what a slap in the face for the parents to delete her Tumblr, man. How fucked up is that? You can't just, like, it's out there on the internet. What the fuck's wrong with you? Like, do they not know that that actually makes it worse? That is so disrespectful. Like, that was her last words, and you want to fucking delete it like that? Delete her whole vlog or blog, whatever the hell it's called? She did have an other entry that got posted after that. She was kind of going off, though. She said, Mom and Dad, F you, and she was angry. Oh, well, may you rest in peace. So what we learned from this, gang?
To... Just accept everybody, as long as they don't, you know, hurt you. But
yeah, other love than your that, kid, huh? Love your kid. So we'd all pretty much support our kid being a transitional, huh?
Whatever they want to be, as long as they don't hurt other people or hurt themselves. That's all I care about.
Yeah, we're all liberals here. You're just gonna get that generic answer. Of course, everybody love. Nah, but really though, everybody love each other. Be nice, support your kid.
I just think it's backwards if you don't, you know, accept people and just continue this vicious cycle of bullying people and just making fun of people because they're different, you know?
They had to move her funeral because there were going to be a bunch of protesters. And so they had to do it at a secret date and location.
Mm-hmm.
Because too many people were going to protest it and stuff. Because they don't want Jacob on the tombstone. They want the name that she wanted. So now there's a tombstone. Like, that's like another slap in the face. Fucking putting dear beloved son Jacob, whatever. Like, that's not how she went out. The reason she killed her, like, your daughter killed them. Your child killed themselves because you didn't want to let them be who they want to be, and then. You're gonna slap. So that's just fucked up, man.
Is there an aftermath of how the parents feel at the moment? Because I don't know how one would feel and not even consider what they're doing is kind of.
They're wrong. They're so clueless. The mom went on CNN and she kept emphasizing son this, son that, good boy Jacob. Like, she's just totally not even acknowledging any of his feelings. Like, on her Facebook post, like, before she had to lock down her Facebook, it said, our beloved son went out for a late walk and was struck by a car. No, your kid f- felt alienated and unloved and unwanted and like a piece of shit and snuck out and committed suicide because you just didn't want to show him any support.
Well, isn't that very unreligious of her to lie?
I think it's not that she's lying. I think she's just in denial.
Well, you know what? Either way, all of the things that she's doing is actually helping her son slash daughter, her child. Because every time she goes against the grain, it just raises more and more awareness, which is in turn is giving this kid, Jacob, Leela, exactly what they wanted when they left, period. So, I don't know, this kind of ties into that question about, you know, losing all the battles and winning the war. This is a prime example of what that is right there, you know? Felt like he was losing a battle every time, and now, you know, unfortunately he's gone, and he doesn't see the legacy he left behind, but he's winning. Every time the parents say something they shouldn't be saying, it's another bit of awareness for people just like them. So,
if Leela would have stuck it out for 2 more years, she could have gotten to a home or something. There's a lot of support groups.
Right.
Okay. So the person who asked me to comment on this, who brought this, like, I honestly didn't know about the story at first until an actual viewer told me about it and I looked into it. And then I found the Reddit account and like, I was just like, that's like, I don't know. That's the thing I do. Whenever I find out someone prolific kills themselves, I'm like, what was their Reddit account? What was their vlog? What was their Facebook?
Reddit.
And she was a nice person, a cool person. Anyways, if they would have just fucking hung in there for 2 more years and moved down, found some support in a home, whatever, you didn't have to die. And if anyone out there feels like that, where you're unwanted by your parents, I love, like, there's hotlines and there is support groups out there. There really is. You just gotta hang in there. But, because Leela actually posted a couple of, not suicide notes, but she was on, like, the Reddit Suicide Watch subreddit. And people are like, no, you don't need to kill yourself. Like, they're actually trying to help her. But I think she had just lost it. She was on that deep end.
I mean, you've been going through it for, let's say, what, 16 years? You know? If you've been doing something for so long, you feel like at some point, you're going to feel like there's no end of the road here, you know?
Exactly.
Like, when does it stop? When does it stop if you've been going through this for so long? I mean, honestly, I still feel the same way. I still should have held out, but it's, I don't know, I guess because we're not in that shoot.
We're not young, because I remember when I was young, I wanted to leave the house, but I didn't think about the long terms where maybe I should have went a different route and, like, made bank being a doctor or a finance person, but, you know, there's that. I was young. I didn't think about those things. And I'm pretty sure she didn't too. And to a teenager, if she's stripped away of her internet, no contact with people, homeschooling, day by day, it's going to feel like years and years, even though it could have been like a month, you know?
Yeah. And to make matters worse, you're left to your own thoughts and your own, you know, not a lot of people can handle being inside their own mind. You
solitary.
Know what I'm
saying? Solitary can do shit to you.
Some people can't handle it. Most humans are not made for that, straight up. To be alone, to be all that, they'll kill themselves, as you can see here. They'll eat themselves alive. All this disparity and all this other crazy crap going on in their mind, they'll make themselves feel a lot worse than they should.
Yeah.
And that was pretty much all that was left. At the end of the day, it sucks. It sucks.
Yeah, she had no outlet because she couldn't go on the internet. She couldn't text her friends. She couldn't hang out with her friends. Go to church around people that you don't like, and then come home, and that's it. That's it. And then your mind just fucking races and races, and you start just like getting suicidal and shit. But yeah, like solitary confinement, whatever. A lot of prisoners don't want to go there because it'll just drive you mad.
Yeah.
Yeah, like me would tell you, she done a hard time. You know, I was wondering, well, how would the Call of Duty community react if, like, a famous gamer all of a sudden say, you know what, I'm gonna be a woman. I want to be a woman now, everybody.
I have no idea. We have yet to see that.
Man, to be honest, I'm frightened.
Because you know how the Call of Duty community is, you know, young males.
I'm gonna say it. I'm gonna straight up say it. They're not educated.
You gotta make your announcement. Okay, go ahead, Dosh.
They're too ignorant. They're too ignorant. The problem with all of these things and people making these decisions and choices is that those that catch wind of it and hear about this aren't educated enough to make the decisions of how to go about, you know, approaching it. You know what I'm saying? Like, they're too ignorant to everything. So if somebody from the card community changed their gender and then announced it, they'd eat that poor person alive just because they couldn't handle it.
Wait.
So you're a fag now? Ha ha, LOL, faggot, and N-word for no reason, faggot. Like, it's just...
Dosha, now that you talk about that, isn't there a very famous person in the FGC community that switched genders and everybody's pretty much digging that person?
Oh, yep.
And I'll say that.
And she's hot as fuck.
Ricky Ortiz.
Well, Ricky Ortiz is gay, right?
No. He changed genders.
Really?
Ricky Ortiz changed gender. All right, let me
Hello
just bring
Kitty,
up.
Hello, Kitty.
I know who you're thinking about.
I'm thinking about the Japanese one.
Yeah, you're thinking about KO Police. But let me bring up Ricky Ortiz for a second.
Wait, now, is that
Ricky
his?
There's two then.
Yeah, there's a bunch. It's like three, to be honest. There's a lot of them.
And people are very accepting in that community, which I'm surprised. You know,
Here's the thing. For two reasons. Number one, Ricky Ortiz has been a part of the fighting game community since a long time, right?
But that doesn't matter. Can you imagine a long-time Call of Duty person announcing that? And
yeah, but here's what I'm saying. They had a chance to get to know this person and to get wise and learn about this. You know what I'm saying? That's what I'm getting at. Whereas the same, like, and I'm just talking about the community. Now, when Ricky Ortiz shows up on stream, right? The stream monsters and the people that are watching that really aren't a part of the community, they make the gay jokes. They're the ones saying, LOL, faggot, this, that, and the third. They're the one calling Ricky out on, you know, her name because she changed genders. You know, that's the point that I was getting at with that. That's why I veered away from KO Police for a second, who is a prime example, and she is pretty.
There she is, right here.
But now, we got Ricky Ortiz. And it's even worse because now it's like, some people, and it's just a heartbreaker because some people who've known Ricky for so long and are so used to calling her he, right? Because, like, Ricky didn't mind how you address her. If you've known her for a long time and you say he, she gets it. It's whatever.
Mm-hmm.
But, like, now there's all this controversy saying, how many times are these people going to call her a him? They should address her properly. And she's like, it doesn't matter because they're not ignorant to it. It's just they're so conditioned. They've known me for so long like this. I haven't forced anybody to accept me like this. I commend Ricky because she does whatever the hell she wants. She wanted to be a girl. She changed it to a girl. No matter what y'all say. Like, and everybody got educated and hip to it.
Exactly.
She's still part of EG. She's still bringing home the bacon. She's still, you know what I'm saying, whooping ass in Street Fighter, picking whoever she wants. Actually, she picks Poisons just to celebrate the fact that she's transgender. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's good. But I don't think Call of Duty could handle something like that.
All right, but at the end of the day, though, would you hit it?
What the fuck? Man, where my pre-workout drink at? I'm about to drink this shit and get off the internet, and I'm done with you, Mike.
but hit Google KO Police, KO Sorta, and it's like just different articles.
She's pretty cute.
She's going to be releasing a semi-nude photo book. Damn. Satoa was born a male. Something she finally revealed last fall on a Japanese TV program.
Mm-hmm.
Huh. So does she still have a thingy down there? Or?
I don't know. My dad haven't checked.
No, I haven't looked up on this girl, but that's what sparked my idea when I just like heard Shidosha talk, and I was like, oh yeah, FGC community. They have people there, and people are very supportive, so...
Yeah, there's multiple, yeah, but for the most part, the community's supportive, but the street monsters, man, you know, they just... Monsters will be monsters.
Although, there's a League of Legends, I don't think this person's pro, called BoxBox, and he dresses up as Riven, and people gaga over him.
And he must have nice hair.
I can tell you, whenever I think of Riven, this beautiful champion, which is a girl, I think of him, and he looks beautiful, and stream monsters love him. So, and he's an amazing League of Legends player. So,
like
I really think
it's they do the same to Cutie Pie. It's funny. Like,
I really think it's just the audience.
So, KO Police is releasing her first photo book titled Reborn. And she talks about ditching school as a kid, her attempted suicide. That's like a common thing, sadly. Her attempted suicide, living her life in secret. According to Sato, she began injecting herself with hormones from 15 years old. Damn, started early. She hasn't undergone any surgery. So there you go. That answers that.
Still swinging. Still hey, swinging.
But you know, it's the best of both worlds. You know how it is, Dosha. You know what I mean?
Go away. Sometimes you just want to try some things.
You know how it is, Dosha. I mean, am I right? Wait. You know.
But you guys know,
like, back in the day of, like, the Greeks and all those, like, Roman times when people were off to war, men got a little frisky. If you actually read through the history books, they did.
I read, just saying,
people have, you know, touched stick to butt. It's happened. And
that's kind of the reason why people make fun of 300 and all that stuff. Yeah. It's like, oh, everyone's wearing these 300 outfits. They don't know what it means. Ha ha ha. Dick in the booty, dick in the booty. I'm like, all
right. Wait, back up. Huh? 300 means dick in the booty.
No, that's not. Oh, God damn it. Now you're going to make the meme.
In that tense of that genre back in the day during the 300 times, people used to poke at each other because they're away from home. They didn't have their women. Sex. Yeah. Huh. And that's why I think it's so funny now, like, well, thank God we are, you know, evolving as humans, I hope, and people are more accepting. But people used to do that shit back then and nobody really said shit.
Like lesbians too?
I'm pretty sure people did whatever they wanted, but
did you hear the way he said things? Like,
I know.
What?
I don't scissoring. Can I just say something? I really legit do not know how scissoring works, even though I know what it looks like.
Oh, come on. Scissoring?
I know what that looks, but I don't know. It doesn't work in my head. It doesn't work.
Okay. Well, obviously, I haven't scissored. Hey, you know what I always wondered?
What?
I always wondered, like, who was the first people that did gay sex? Like, girl on girl, guy, whatever, like. How did that happen?
I don't know.
When do you think that happened? Like hundreds of years ago? 100 years ago?
I don't know, but I feel like they had a trend. There's, you know, like you ever hear like the stories of the forbidden fruit? They always run away to like the forest, some forbidden or some discreet place in the middle of nowhere, and then they just kind of do their thing. Like, I feel like that's what happened.
I don't know, just like where they what happened? Like, was some like two dudes wrestling one day? And one of them popped a boner, and he's like, hey, where does this go? Oh, well, I guess there's only one place for it to go. No? Okay.
I think we need to travel back in time, Mikey.
All right, let's go. And then, like, how did scissoring start?
I'm not too sure, like, Mikey. You need to go back in time and track these people down.
Yeah, like, screw the pyramids and Easter Island. I want to know how scissoring started. That's the real mystery. Fuck how our solar system came into existence. The real thing is scissoring. All right, anyways, but we've been bullshitting for a while. Should we talk about what we pimping, what we plan, what we doing, all that shit?
Let's do it.
So I'm gonna be doing more scissoring. I mean, more streaming. probably some. I got a new video game. Dragon Age.
Ooh, Inquisition?
Dragon Age, I'm going to try that out, play that. I play Game of Thrones, and it is good.
Did you finish?
It is good. It's a two-hour video game, Telltale. It's good. If you like Game of Thrones, get it. You'll like it.
I will definitely
stream it. Your viewers will like it. It's fun. Announce it ahead of time, because you don't want to get into that midway. It's good. It is very much in the theme of the HBO show. It's worth it. It's $5.
Is there sex?
No, it's a video game.
But it's Game of Thrones.
Well, maybe there is, but we haven't gotten to that
part. You haven't played it yet though, right?
No,
I've played it. Actually, I played it. Yeah, I played it on Wednesday.
Listen,
and I played through the whole thing. Yeah, it was a fun ride. It was a fun ride.
So maybe there will be, because so far it's been very in line. Okay. Very in line with the series. And best of all, you know, it's got the voices of people. Right?
Cersei. It's got Tyrion. Tyrion's in it. So you know there's going to be a sex scene.
Tyrion. Cersei. Sansa wasn't in there.
I didn't see Sansa. I saw, who was the Stark that got sent to the wall? I forgot his name.
Jon Snow.
Jon Snow.
Yes.
Who's that other fucking princess? The one that was that married Joffrey last.
Oh, the one that looked like Michelle Pfeiffer. I forgot her name.
She's cute, but she's in there. Yes. And I can't even think of her damn name. But they got the voices of the actors, and it has their likeness. Although, Cersei, they made her look kind of younger.
Is Khaleesi there?
Yeah, well, I've seen thumbnails.
There's pictures of Khaleesi in it. Like, Erin Riddle, a dragon drawn. So I'm thinking episode 5, Khaleesi will make a big...
I'm thinking everyone's... I mean, they're showing all these characters and their voices. Yeah. So yeah, they're going to be in it. I think they realize the first Game of Thrones game, it sucked ass. I had nothing to deal with the series. What's very cool is, if you're a fan of the series, the events, like, take place, like, outside things that happen in the show. It's very cool. Like, you're like, oh, so this is happening at the same time. This is, but from a different angle. Like, oh, they're outside the castle when this happens. And, like, you actually see people walking by who you see in the TV show on camera, but from a different angle. It's really cool. Alright? So you should get it, Mew.
Okay, definitely.
So I play that. I gonna play Dragon Age. Gonna play Destiny. Play the new zombies. So follow me on Twitch, Twitter, Facebook. Social links down below. What about you, Mew? What you doing?
I have been streaming. Because I know someone like wrote somewhere like, Mew, you have been streaming. No, I've been streaming. Probably not during your time, but... my stream schedule is Wednesday and Sunday, 9 p.m. Eastern. I usually stream for like 3 hours. And I will stream randomly at random times off those streams. And on YouTube, I have a lot of unboxing videos as usual. So you guys can check that out. And I'm going to upload a Halo clip very, very soon. So if you guys want to see me play the Halo 5 beta.
No Halo in the title. We forgot to talk about that.
I heard about that. That thing you can't put Halo because Microsoft wrote that. I'm still fucking putting Halo 5. I'm going to test the fucking waters.
You're going to get a strike. Knock your ass down, girl.
Can I just say something? What about all the people who have Halo 5 already up still?
I don't know.
Exactly.
I don't get it. Halo's not as popular.
I know, exactly.
Like, oh, hey, you know what would be great, guys? Let's not put Halo in the titles.
Like, what the fuck? Like, what are you thinking? Like, not put Forza in the title? Like, this is very fast driving game.
I think they're going to fix it, but go on.
No, because I was going to say the most ridiculous thing is they didn't want people to mistaken that it's been put out by them. When I'm like, clearly you can tell this is a kid or this is a person playing the game. Not official stuff.
Yeah. Maybe we can talk more about it by next week. And hopefully by next week they'll come around. Because Nintendo had a very similar problem. And then they came around. So there's some... It's so bizarre. We'll talk about it next time. So what else? Is that it? You're going to post Halo?
Yeah, I'm going to be posting some Halo clips and some Lee clips. And that's pretty much for me. And Jacob asked me to say this in an Ari voice, which is from League. Say cheese. Okay.
Danny's wet. Oh, creepy. My gosh.
Have a Shadosha.
No.
All right. So surprise. I'm working on an animation, actually, with a friend of mine. So I'm not going to leak too much information about that just yet. But it does have to do, funny thing, we were talking about Minecraft today. And when I was writing out the script, I was like, the only thing that I can use to get the point across, I want to make it gaming related, is Minecraft. So it's going to have some Minecraft themed stuff to it. But it's for everybody. It's going to be fun. Now, of course, you know, ADA is coming out tomorrow. I got a lot of questions. It's going to be great. And, it's been ridiculous. So that's going to be happening. Still streaming. I've been playing a little bit less Payday. I'm still playing it, but I've been trying to mix up a few things since people wanted to see Game of Thrones. They wanted me to finish Nancy Drew. So, you know, all that's been happening. And that's it. That's all. God damn it.
Okay, so it's been a great talk. Just be nice to people.
I know.
Okay, I actually learned a lot about transgender people creeping on through Leela's postings because I was being nosy, but I learned a lot. I learned a lot through the insight. I realized how tough it is for them. I had no idea that their suicide rate is like fucking 40%. It's insane. It's crazy. And they're legit going through problems. Be nice to, if someone comes at you like that, be supportive. you need to be there for them, even if you don't completely understand it. I get it. I got those parents' point of view. Just be nice and loving and understanding of other people's points of view. Know what I mean? Like I said, I understand those parents' point of view. I do get it. Just be more loving. That's all. Got to be more understanding to each other. Okay? That's pretty much the moral of today's story, I think. Right? That's a good message for the day.
Yay, Mikey!
Love and understanding and rainbows.
I love you.
Good. Great talking. We'll see you next time. Bye.
Bye.